In Sri Lanka, most villagers survive on daylight. Electricity has been a mere dream for them. That is why each day when dusk settles in, they huddle around the faint light of a kerosene lamp. With the help of this light, mothers prepare food and children read books. But the Energy Services Delivery Project has lifted them from their plight, dispelling this perennial gloom. This World Bank and Global Environment Facility assisted project of the Government of Sri Lanka is managed by the administrative unit established within the DFCC Bank. The ESD project receives funds from the International Development Association and the Global Environment Facility. These are then channeled through participating credit institutions such as the DFCC Bank, National Development Bank, Hatton National Bank, Sampat Bank, Commercial Bank and Sarvodaya Economic Enterprise Development Services. The ESD credit program provides financing to private enterprises, NGOs and cooperatives for off-grid village hydro schemes, solar home systems, grid-connected mini hydro schemes, other renewable energy investments and demand-side management. Power is generated through ecologically friendly renewable sources of energy. Grant financing is available for selected technical assistance activities relating to village hydro projects and solar home systems. This is Polpitigama, a remote village in the Kurunagala district. Earlier, only kerosene lamps illuminated this village. People were bowed down in hardships. Television and radio were a remote luxury. Villagers would need to trek miles to recharge a rundown battery. But now, things have changed. The Energy Services Delivery Project has brought solar power to this village. In other words, the sun's energy is provided for them night and day. Aruni Nisansala has been sewing for the last 10 years. Whenever she had to meet a deadline, she used to work into the night with the help of a kerosene lamp. But now, with solar power, working at night is no longer a problem. Solar energy provides light at night and during the day.
මේ පොලිතුම කොට්ටාසේ පුරා අපි සූර්ය බල ශක්ති ව්‍යාප්තියක් ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන යනවා. ඒ අනුව පොල්පිටගම මහව ගණේවත්ත ගල්ගමු කියන ප්‍රදේශයේ
RM Bandaranaik says that four villages in this area have benefited from solar energy. During the last 3 years, 300 solar panels have been installed under this credit program and the recovery rate is 100%. Solar energy is used to illuminate their homes and to watch television. According to Bandaranaike, the project is very successful. Suppliers of solar panels play a key role in installing, maintaining and providing technical advice. The Solar Industries Association promotes the use of panels island-wide. Customers simply choose what they can afford. Berannawa is a tiny village in the Kagala district. With the help of the ESD project, the villagers built a dam across the stream and set up a hydropower scheme. This is its turbine. A village committee played a key role in setting up the scheme.
මේ ඉඩම හේතුන් බැලුවේ අපි
The turbine is located at Mutumandara's land. He says he donated the land as it was the most suitable place for the turbine. Out of the total cost of the project, 40% came from the people's own labor. A fruitful project. This is just the story of two villages. By now, hundreds of such villages have been illuminated. Their lives too have been lit up. Gunaratnamanike has been facing untold suffering before this hydropower scheme was implemented in her village. Earlier, she totally depended on kerosene lamps and trekked miles to get a battery charged to watch television. Now, she has been spared that hassle. The ESD project has also funded many mini hydro projects that supply power to the national grid. Mini hydro projects are commercial initiatives executed by private sector developers. This mini hydro project in Malibada in the Kagala district is one such project. The ESD project has also assisted the Ceylon Electricity Board to set up a pilot wind farm project in Hambantota. The power generated by this is fed to the national grid. The Ceylon Electricity Board also provided CFL bulbs under easy payment schemes as a part of demand side management. Now, gradually, hundreds of remote villages across the country are coming out of the perennial darkness into the light.